Hello guys and welcome to Amul's Academy. From today we are going to start C programming series and this is the first tutorial in this series. So here today we are discussing about the introduction part of C programming language. Nowadays computer became an essential part of our life. In every field we'll use computers. And this computer was introduced in 19th century by Charles Babbage, and this is called as a computational device or a programmable device. That is nothing but computer can't do anything without programs. And here program is nothing but set of instruction. That is, a programmer will give instruction to the computer, and that instructions is called as program. Okay, to give instruction we need to communicate with the computers. For that we need language. For example, if you want to communicate with your friends or other people, you want language, right? In same way, to give instruction or to communicate with the computers, we need language, and this language is called as programming language because these languages are used to write these programs. So this is called as programming language, and different types of programming languages are present and we'll discuss few. Okay, here are the different types of programming language: low level language, middle level language and high level language. In the low level language, there are two types. One is called as machine language and another one is assembly language. And first we'll discuss about the machine language. Computers only understand machine language. Computer is a machine, right? So it understands machine language. And this machine language contains streams of zeros and ones. So it is in the form of binary. Binary format contains only two values, right? 0 and 1. So machine language contains binary format. Computer can recognize the electric signal, right? So if electric signal is present, then it is noted as 1. If electric signal is absent, then it is noted as 0. So computer is a machine which can recognize the electric signal. So if electric signal is present, then it is denoted as 1. If it is absent, then it is denoted as 0. So this computer can understand this machine language. Alright. So we can show this in a picture. Here is a programmer. And here is our system. And here programmer will write program in machine language. Okay, it contains 0101, something like that. Okay, now it is given to the computer. In the computer there will be a processor. It will execute this instruction, and here this code is different for different processor. So this is called as machine dependent language. It's because this machine code is varies for different processor. Here, machine easily understand machine code, so it will execute the instruction easily. But we means humans need to write this code, and this code is very difficult to understand. Because of this, other languages are developed. And one of them is assembly language. This assembly language is similar to the machine code, and this is also called as symbolic machine code. Here only difference is numbers are replaced by words. That is, for example, if you want to add two numbers, then in machine code we'll write something like this. Okay, that means it contains only 0 and 1s. If we write same code in the assembly, then we'll write like this, add and numbers. So here we can see words are replaced by the numbers. we can show like this. Here is a programmer and here is our system, right? And this programmer will write programs in assembly language. That is, it contains something, add, sub, something like that. Okay. Now we need to give this instruction to the computer. But the problem is, computer won't understand assembly language. It only understand machine code. But here we wrote our instruction in assembly language. So now we need to convert this assembly language to machine code. For example, if you go to another country and you want to communicate with a person who don't know any other language except his local language, and you don't know that local language, then what will you do? You will use a converter or a mediator, right, to convert your language to his, to do communication. In the same way, here machine won't understand assembly language, so we need to convert this assembly language to machine code. For that, we'll use a program called assembler. This assembler will convert this assembly code to machine code. And then processor will execute that instruction. Here, this assembly code also machine dependent. That means this code will vary for different processor. Alright. Even though this assembly language is quite understandable than the machine code, but we need lot of practice to understand this language. So to make it easy for programmers, many human readable languages are developed. That is, now we'll discuss about the middle level language. An example for this is C, C++ language. So here we can see C is a middle level language. And this middle level language shares feature of both high level and low level language. That is, it is human readable like high level language. And here we can control processor like low level language. That is, it is human readable. And here we can understand how actually computer works like in the lower level language. So before going to C, we'll see the high level language. And high level languages are more human friendly. It is human readable code. And here we can't understand how actually computer works. And example for this is Ruby, Python, C Sharp, Java. So if we draw a picture here, he is a programmer and he'll write program in the high level language or mid level language. Okay. Now here is our system. This machine won't understand this high level or mid level language, right? So we need to convert this high level or mid level language to machine code. For that, we'll use compiler or interpreter. So this compiler and interpreter will do same work, that is converting high or mid-level language to machine code. And here, high and mid-level languages are machine independent. That is, we can run our programs in any computers. As I said, compiler and interpreter will do same work, that is converting high or middle level language to machine code. But difference is in the way of working. In the compiler, it will convert the whole file to machine code, then it will execute that. For example, if it is my source code or the written program, then I'll give this file to the compiler. Then it will generate the machine code. That is, it will convert whole file to the machine code and it will execute that. But in the interpreter, it will convert the code line by line. That is, if it is my source code, it will check for the first line and it will convert that to machine code. Then it will execute that. Then it will check for the second line and it will convert that to machine code and then it will execute. So in the interpreter, it will convert the code line by line. If you take a general example, before exam, you'll ask one of your friend to explain a concept which you are not getting. So he can explain you in two ways. First way is he can read the whole content, then he'll explain you. So this is compiled language. Here, he'll take more time to analyze the answer and less time to explain you. So in the compiler, it will take more time to analyze but less time to execution. And another way is he can read the first line of the content and he can explain you. Then he'll read the second line and he'll explain you. This is interpreted language, where he'll take less time to analyze the answer, but overall time of explaining is more. So here in the interpreter, it will take less time to analyze and more time to execution. Okay, this is about the compiled and interpreted language. Now we'll discuss about the history of C. C was developed in 1972 and it was developed by Dennis Ritchie at Bell Laboratory. So C was born at 1972, father is Dennis Ritchie and it is developed in Bell Laboratories. But why he named this language as C? What actually C means? He named this language as C because it derives some features from language B, which is the stripped down version of BCPL language, Basic Combined Programming language. And after B, C comes, right? So he named this language as C programming language. As we can see, this programming language was developed in 1972. So it is a 30 plus year old language. Then why we need to learn this language? After this language, there are many other high level languages are developed, then why C? Okay, now our question is why C? It is because first reason is it is a middle level language. We already discussed about the middle level language, right? It shares the properties of both low level and high level language. So by learning C, we'll come to know how actually computer works, as well as it is a human readable language, so it is easy to understand this language. Okay, second reason is it is a compiled language. So just now we discussed about the compiled and interpreted language, and compiled language take less time for execution. So it is one of the reason. And third reason is it is machine independent, so we can run our code in any computer. And fourth is, if you want to learn C++ Java, then there are key concepts like polymorphism, class, object, inheritance. In that time, if you don't know C, then along with that key concepts, we need to learn the basic concepts also. Instead of that, if you already know C, then you can concentrate only on the key concepts. So it will become easy to learn that language. And the fifth reason is some parts of OS like Windows, Linux are still written in C, because coming to the performance of programming language, nothing can beat C. Okay, these are very few reasons to learn C programming language. There are many. Okay, this is about the introduction part of C programming language. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe my channel. I'll meet you in next class. Till then, take care.